Stop this. Why are you doing this to me? No.
God for help, you dog.
We need to start the ceremony soon. I can't stall these people any longer or they'll fake sniffle their way out of this place. And where's Jason?
I don't know. He didn't even bother calling. I say we just get on with the ceremony.
My deepest condolences to you and your brother, Marcus. It must be terrible to be orphaned so early in life.
No worst pain in the world, ma'am. Thank you for coming, though. My father was really fond of you both.
Speaking of us, where's Jason? What a son. Missing his own father's funeral.
Unfortunately, Jason's been pretty preoccupied lately. Busy in making the legacy that I can only wish I would own. Thank you for coming, though.
Okay, I'll see you when I get there. Yes, I understand it is very urgent, but you see, I haven't even left home yet. Okay, I'll see you soon then. Bye.
Sir, this is the medication for your bruising and injury. Just make sure you take them regularly. Sir? Are you listening to me?
Oh, I'm sorry. This is just some research I've been working on, you see. And yes, I was listening to you. Thank you very much. Hi, brother.
What on earth happened to your face?
I don't know. I got into some trouble last night near the office.
Do you know how embarrassing that was for me? Dad's advisor criticized me for it.
Look, it was already past when the funeral was supposed to start. I was...
It's okay. It's not like he cost me the last bit of dignity that I had left.
Yeah, do you know how pathetic I looked? Asking everyone to wait for the ceremony to start because the dead man's son hadn't shown up.
See, I'm really sorry, okay? He was my father too. I would never miss his funeral on purpose. Now if you'll excuse me, there's some work I need to attend to. Good morning, Stanley. To the office, please. Hello?
Hey, Jason. I wanted to know if you're free for lunch. I was thinking maybe Adesia, around 1.
Yeah, about that. Listen, I don't think I can make it there today. My face is still hideous from yesterday and I'm a bit tied up from work.
Actually, I had something important I wanted to discuss about. It's about your father, before he passed.
Yeah, I'm really sorry about that. I just don't have the time right now.
Okay, I was gonna go out with my friends anyway. But remind me to tell you. It's something you might want to know.
Yeah, don't worry. I will. Hello, Miss Ackley. Care to join me?
Sure. Just call me Margaret.
Oh, okay. Yes, so what is it that you so urgently needed to discuss?
Jason, there's some important things that you need to know that were discussed at your father's board meeting last month.
Yes. I asked Marcus about that. Apparently, they discussed some trade plans and marketing strategies, but it's nothing that I already did not know. But thank you, ma'am, for your consideration. So, are we done yet?
I think you forgot to mention some crucial details that you need to know about. You know what? Maybe we should discuss this later.
Hey, on second thoughts, I think I'll see you at Adesia. Yeah, I thought I had a meeting, but it's been cancelled, so see you at 1?
Yeah, but I'm with my friends. You'll have to hang out with all of us.
Yeah, okay, sure.
I'm sorry, who are you?
No one important. All you need to know is that you'll have dire consequences if you meet up with Jason, and he should get this message too.
Yeah, hilarious. What is it that you actually want? Money or something?
No one cares about the money, Emily. My boss only cares about getting the upper hand.
So, all I want is for you to see to it that my boss gets the message, man.
Yeah, okay. I'll let him know that a creep wants in on his bank account.
Mind your words, miss. You never know who might hear them, especially with my boss.
You don't want to take chances saying things like that.
What? Where's Emily? She's not the one to be late.
Good morning, Miss Ackley.
Oh yes, about that. Maybe I should wait for the lawyer to come here first.
Oh, cut the formalities. You were ready to tell me this yesterday. What happened?
Okay. Prior to your father's passing last month, he'd held a board meeting that you were absent for. Now, Marcus may have told you some of what Elias said, but not all of it.
Ladies and gentlemen, I, the chairman of United Trade, would like to announce that I have officially executed my will, and I'm proud to say that my wonderful son Jason will be the next CEO of United Trade. Yes, and my other son Marcus, he will be a future operations manager. Although if Jason is still away, researching and hopefully discovering something that may help us expand in the future, when the time comes for my will to be put into action, Marcus will fill the esteemed shoes of a CEO.
So you see, I think Marcus may be jealous of all this wealth that you will inherit. After the meeting, the copy of the will that I received stated that you should only be inheriting a few acres of ancestral land. That does not match up to what your father had said at the board meeting. By his word, you should be the CEO of United Trade.
Yes, but what can I do about it right now? Marcus has already filled that position, and besides, it's not like he's doing a bad job.
Look into it, Jason. Ask Marcus about it.
Explain this to me, Marcus.
Explain what? It's just the will. Dad wrote it himself.
You know exactly what I'm talking about. You were there at the board meeting when this will was discussed. I was supposed to be the CEO.
Look, Jason, by questioning the will, you're questioning Dad's choices. And in doing so, you're questioning his jurisdiction. I say you should just go with it. It'll benefit you greatly.
Yeah, and besides, didn't you want land for some research anyway? You should be satisfied you got what you wanted. I mean, while you've been away, researching or whatever, Marcus has been here, handling the company. He deserves what he got, unlike you. If you think you can just barge in here and expect everything to be in your way, you're royally mistaken. Have some gratitude for the fact that you get to frolic in your cornfields.
I understand what you guys are saying, but ever since I returned from the UK, strange things have been happening to me and it just doesn't add up. But I have every reason to believe that this will have something to do with it.
Look, Jason, let me lay it down straight for you. You've got two options here. One, you just be happy with the land that you've been appointed and let me handle Dad's company. Or you take this to court. And I can assure you it won't be an easy battle to win.
Fine, we'll play it your way. Oh, and one more thing. Make sure your hands are clean because you never know what the future might hold. Hello? Okay, I'll be there tomorrow, first thing in the morning. Yeah, I'm a bit tied up right now. Okay, see you. Sorry guys, it was a call from the lab. Okay, I came here as soon as possible. What happened?
You're calm. I need to show you something. Look at this. This is a 12-week sample. Now watch this.
Wow.
Amazing, isn't it? Rice seems to be growing 20% faster and wheat about 15%. We finally invented our hormone after 6 years of hard work.
Wow, that's amazing. This means we have met our targets. This is going to revolutionize food security.
Yes, yes.
You know what? Since you discovered this hormone, I shall credit its name to your name. And therefore, we shall call this Alexon.
Thank you, sir.
You know, it'll soon become the prime time for you to put those plant growth hormones that you were researching into the market.
Yeah, I know, but I just don't know how though.
Well, why don't you start a food security company? With the technology we've developed, we'll be able to produce 5 times the normal harvest every year. And we'll be the biggest sellers in the market.
I called you here today to discuss a business proposal that I have for a new food security company.
Monetizing chaos, huh?
Of course.
Do you plan to put this new research of yours to test?
Precisely. So, what do you think?
I think we can make this work.
secure our food through agri-trade, the food crisis has suddenly gotten worse.
Yeah, it seems like a good idea. It will keep our future safe too.
What, Marcus, have you seen this?
Well, that's great. Let's put father's money to good use then.
Yes, the generous investments that all of you have made have borne their fruit, as this company has made profits within the first 6 months of its launch date. Not to mention our share prices, which have been steadily growing since day one and show no sign of coming down now.
Now on that note, let's get this party started!
They said this day wouldn't come and we refuse to run. We've only just begun. You'll find us chasing the sun.
Give me a second, hold on one minute. What do you want, Marcus? Okay. Jason, it's Marcus. He wants to talk to you right now.
Tell him to call me tomorrow.
Jason, it's urgent. He needs to talk to you right now. Trust me, you want to listen to what he has to say.
Okay. Hello, Marcus. What's up? Why do you call me?
I want you to hand over all of Aggravation's shares to me. The amount of profit you're making of the food crisis is unbelievable. Not even tech companies match up to it. I want it.
What? Are you serious? There's no way I'm gonna hand them all over to you.
Well, I'll think you'll want to. I've got some very, very important people with me. Welcome, brother. I've been waiting for you a while.
Where are my friends? Emily and Alex.
Where are my shares?
They're in your plan, not in mine.
Well then, it's time to change your plans.
Those shares don't belong to you. They belong to the future.
Well, then you die the same way that father did. In my hands.
You killed father?
Yes, it's time for you to die now.
You killed father, but I cannot kill my own brother.